I'm now going to talk about what's called the expected value of a random variable, also called the expectation of a random variable. And what this is going to give us is a way to compute an average value that a random variable takes on. This is going to generalize the concept of the arithmetic mean from math, where, for example, if we had three numbers, 3, 5, and 10, to compute the arithmetic mean, I add up these three numbers and divide the sum by how many numbers there are, in this case, 3. So the top here is 18 divided by 3, so this is 6. And a different way to think about this is that I'm taking 3 and weighting it by 1/3, and then I'm adding 5 weighted by 1/3, and I'm adding 10 weighted by 1/3. Okay? You can think of it as 3, 5, and 10, I'm treating them as having equal weights, as if they're equally likely. And how expected value is going to generalize the arithmetic mean is by saying, well, I can have these weights be different. So for example, if I think 3 is more likely, then I'll increase this weight and decrease these weights. Okay, and if we think of this as a probability distribution for what's in red, then if I have a random variable x with probability table given by 3, 5, 10, and probabilities 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, then what I'm doing is I'm taking each label, multiplying it by the weight here, I'm repeating that for all of them, and then I'm adding them up. So if instead I had a different probability table here, 3, 5, and 10, where I have the probabilities 2/3, 1/6, and 1/6, then the expected value of x would be 3 times 2/3 plus 5 times 1/6 plus 10 times 1/6, which is equal to 2 plus 15 over 6. Okay? In general, what we're doing is, again, we're taking the labels here, multiplying each label by the probability, then we're adding up the products here. So importantly, the labels here need to be things that we can actually add up. So we're going to restrict ourselves to having these labels be real valued numbers. And so in general, the expected value denoted by this E here with two lines of X is going to be equal to the sum over all the possible labels here, which is all little x within the alphabet script X of values that X takes on, the label little x times the probability that x is equal to little x. Okay? So something to note here is that this works whenever I have a probability table where these things here are numbers, right? So in particular, if this were a conditional distribution, for example, px given y, okay, we've seen this before. So a conditional probability table is also a probability table. And if the labels are numbers, we can take the expectation. And in that case, the notation used is the expectation of x given y equal to little y is going to be equal to the sum over all the possible labels for little x, and of course the label little x, times the probability of x given y now, because that's the probability table we're looking at, px given y of little x given y. Okay, more is true if we have, for example, f, some function of x. If this thing is a random variable where the labels are numbers, then again, we can look at its probability table and come up with the expected value of the table. Okay? And so how I come up with the probability table for this is first I take the probability table for px. So here I have labels and the probabilities. So the probabilities here are going to stay the same, but I'm going to apply f to each of these labels. It's going to be like I'm relabeling all the different labels by applying f to them. Okay? And so, for example, I could end up with two rows that have the same label, in which case I would combine those two rows and add the probabilities. Okay? So that's how I come up with the probability table for f of x. And if the labels I end up with are numbers, I can again compute the expectation, in which case, if you look at what's going on, the expected value of f of x is actually just going to be, we can write it in terms of the probability table for px. All right, so we're gonna sum over all the possible labels, but we see that the labels are just based on the original values that x can take on. So for all little x within alphabet script x, and then the actual label is now f of little x, and the probability is px of little x. Okay? Okay, so the important thing in all these examples is that as input, we have a probability table, and what we're outputting is a single number, which is the expected value for that table.